Today we shall discuss our two-dimensional random variable. So far we have considered only one-dimensional random variable in which experiments have only one characteristics, and hence what we assigned a single variable will use. In many situations, we will be interested in one, two or more than two characteristics of the outcome of a random experiment. And for example, both voltage and current might be the interest of a certain experiment is an example of two-dimensional random variable in which we assign the two characteristics of the outcomes of a random experiment. The formal definition of random variable in case of two-dimensional, if S be a sample space associated with a random experiment E, let x equal to xs be a x equal to xs and y equal to ys, which means a discrete random variable associated with sample space points, or y is also a discrete random variable or continuous random variable which associated with sample space. B to functions assigning a real number to each outcomes of a sample space, then xy in pair of xy called two-dimensional random variable. If possible values of x and y are finite or countably infinite, then xy is called two-dimensional discrete random variable. Or when x and y is two-dimensional discrete random variable, then possible values of x, y may be regarded as a pair of or ordered pair of x, y, where x denote random discrete random variable x and y denote real values of discrete random variable y, where I should be, or y1, y2, y3 should be finite or countably infinite. In case of countably finite, there are fixed values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, m, or countably infinite in case then the number goes to infinity. So if x and y can assume all values in a specified region R in the xy plane, then xy is called two-dimensional random variable. Probability function of two-dimensional random variable xy, if x and y two-dimensional discrete random variable, such as probability of x equal to xi and y equal to yj, which is denoted by pij. Probability for x equal to xi and y equal to yj, then pij is called probability mass function, or simply probability function of random variable xy, provided the following condition. Following two conditions are satisfied. First one, in case of probability function, pij is always greater than or equal to 0 for every value of I and j. And the second condition, total probability should be 1. So total probability, summation vary from j and summation vary from I, pij is equal to 1. The set of triples, which means random variable x, random variable y, and probability of x equal to xi and y equal to yj, or joint probability of x and y, is called joint probability distribution of x. In the previous slide, we have discussed about discrete random variable and discrete probability and their probability mass function. Now we consider a random variable which are function of a continuous cone. Joint probability density function. If x and y two-dimensional continuous random variable, such that probability of random variable x and y lies in a small interval x minus dxy2 and x plus dxy2, and y lies between y minus dy/2 to y plus dy/2, is equal to function of x, y, dx, dy. We can prove easily this one, because of probability of x minus dx by 2 to x plus dx by 2, which means x vary from x minus dx by 2 to x plus dx by 2, a very small interval of x, and y also vary from x, y minus dy by 2 to y plus dy by 2. dx dy by the definition of probability. Now, in a very small interval of x and y, function of x, y treated a constant value. So, integration of this, if we integrate with respect to x first and then with respect to y, then y dy by 2 and y plus dy by 2, as it is integration of function of x, y, in this case function of x, y treated as constant value in a very small interval. So, integration of with respect to x is equal to x, put the limit of upper limit and lower limit dx by 2 and x plus dx by 2 and dy as it is. Then in this case we get integration of limit dy by 2 upon 2 as it is, y plus dy by 2 as it is, function of x, y, and we put in place of x, x plus dx by 2 and then lower limit x minus dx by 2, we get dx and dy. Now if we integrate with respect to y dx and function of x, y is a constant, so function of x, y, dx as it is, integration of constant with respect to y, y, put the upper limit and lower limit in this case also, we get function of x, y, dx, dy. Then, so function of x, y, for joint function of random variable x and y, called probability density function, if it satisfied these two conditions. First condition, function of probability function always give greater than or equal to 0 value for all value of x, y or all range of which is element of R, and R denote range space in this case. And second, the total probability should be 1. So double integration of joint density function is always equal to 1 in the complete range. Moreover, if D is the subspace of range space R, then probability of x, y in this subspace is given by probability of double integration in the domain of function of x, y with respect to x and with respect to y, or probability of x greater than or equal to and less than equal to b, or y greater than equal to c and less than equal to d is equal to integration of y equal to c to d and integration from x equal to a to b of function of x, y with respect to x and with respect to y. Cumulative distribution function. If two dimensional random variable denoted by x, y, then their cumulative function denoted by capital function of capital F of x, y, joint function of, and which represent probability of x less than equal to x and probability of y less than equal to y and known as a cumulative distribution function. In discrete case, function of x, y equal to summation vary from j and summation vary from I, p, I, j, double summation of joint probability mass function of x, y, where y, j is less than equal to y and x, I is less than equal to x. In continuous case, the range of double integration is minus infinity to y and minus infinity to x in this case, and such probability known as cumulative distribution function of the given joint probability density function. Properties of cumulative distribution function. Cumulative distribution function, if x is constant and is equal to minus infinity, then in this case range of the upper value, range of the x is minus infinity to minus infinity, and in this case integral remains 0. Similarly, for cumulative distribution from x is a variable value and y equal to minus infinity, in this case range of y is starting from minus infinity to infinity, and then this integral remains 0 in this case. So in both the cases, cumulative distribution function should be 0. And if we consider incomplete, and then this is the definition of probability density function. Kx vary from minus infinity to infinity, and then the probability equal to 1. Or sorry, infinity. In this case, write the f vary from cumulative distribution function of infinity to infinity. In this case, probability of x less than equal to infinity and y less than equal to infinity, which is equal to minus infinity to infinity, integration from minus infinity to y, function of x y dx dy, and which is equal to 1 by the definition of probability density function. And similar results for second and third case and fourth case. The last case is also important. At a point of continuity, function of x y, if cumulative distribution function given, then partial differentiation of f with respect to x and with respect to y is equal to probability density or joint probability density function of x and y. So by the last property, we can find probability density function and cumulative distribution function of a of the random variables x and y are known. The next definition or next characteristic of joint density function or joint mass function is marginal probability distribution. Probability of x equal to xi, which means x is fixed and y. So probability of x equal to x and y equal to yj is equal, or probability of x equal to xi, y equal to y2 or etc. value. Or we can write probability of x equal to xi, so pi1 plus pi2 plus and so on is equal to summation, in which summation varies from j equal to 1 to infinity. So this probability distribution where x is a fixed or for marginal value of x or for constant value of x, known as marginal probability function of x, and is defined as pi star, where star denote variable values and I will be constant in this case, or marginal for x equal to xi. The collection of pair xi and pi star is called marginal probability distribution of random variable x. Similarly, we can find the marginal density distribution function or marginal probability distribution of y, in which y is a constant and x varies, so p star j is equal to summation vary from I to the values of different values of y. P I j, you know, joint probability mass function, or we can write probability of y equal to y j. In the continuous case, where x is a fixed value or x lies in a fixed interval, then probability, marginal probability distribution for x represented by probability of x greater than equal to x minus dx by 2 to x plus dx by 2 in a small interval, and y lies in the complete range. So in this case, if we integrate with respect to x, which is lies in a very small interval, then in that case, function of xy is treated as a constant value. And so if we integrate with respect to x, well, then we treat a function of xy as a constant, and therefore integration of this equal to dx. And then remaining integration is integration from minus infinity to infinity, function of xy, integration with respect to y. So in this case, integration from minus infinity to plus infinity of joint probability density function with respect to y, known as marginal density function of x and denoted by f in subscript capital X of x. Similarly, for marginal density function of y, integration vary from minus infinity to infinity, joint density function of xy, integrating with respect to x is called marginal density of y. The next property है conditional probability distribution. condition है हमने probability of x equal to x i when y equal to y j given. so probability of any event a when b has been occurred is given by probability of a and b and divided by probability of b. so in this case probability of x equal to x i and y equal to y j divided by probability of y equal to y j. so in the case of numerator shows probability of x equal to x i and y equal to a joint density function or joint mass sorry joint mass function of random variable x and y denoted by p i j and probability of y equal to y j denote marginal density function of y when y equal to y j p star j. and such probability known as conditional probability of function x given y equal to y j. and similarly we can find the probability conditional probability density function of y given that x equal to x i. the collection of pair is called probability conditional probability distribution of x. and similarly collection of pairs of y and conditional probability of y given that x is known as conditional probability distribution of y when x equal to xi given. example related to conditional marginal and independence of the random. the joint probability dense mass function of x y given by the probability mass function p is equal to k of 2x plus 3y where x vary from 0 1 and 2 and y vary from 1 2 and 3. find the marginal and conditional probability distribution and also find probability distribution of x plus y. so in this case x has the value 0 1 and 2 and y 1 2 and 3 in this case. so joint mass function for x equal to 0 and y equal to 1 we put in the probability mass function p of x y is equal to 2x plus 3y. if we put x equal to 0 and y equal to 1 we get 3k. similarly for x equal to 0 and y equal to 2 we get 6k and in the last case x equal to 0 and y equal to 3 we get 9k. and similarly for remaining values x equal to 1 y equal to 1 x equal to 1 y equal to 2 x equal to 1 y equal to 3 and x equal to 2 and y equal to 3 we get 30k. now given function is a probability mass function given in the question the joint probability mass function of x y. so total probability remain should be 1. so in this case if summation over j and I of p i j is equal to 1. so we add all these values and then equal to 1. 3 plus 6 9 and 18 plus 5 23 31 42 49 59 and 72 k. so total sum of the probability is equal to 72 k and this should be equal to 1 by definition of probability mass function or assumptions of probability mass function. k equal to 1 by 72 in this case. now the marginal density function of x. so for x equal to 0 probability of p i star in this case x equal to 0 we get 3 plus 6 9 plus 3 18 k which is equal to 18 by 72. marginal distribution for x equal to 1 which means x is fixed and y varies. so x equal to 1 y equal to 1 x equal to 1 y equal to 2 and x equal to 1 and y equal to 3 which is equal to 5 plus 8 13 plus 11 24 k for 24 by 70. and in last case marginal density function or marginal distribution for x equal to 2 which is equal to where x equal to 2 fixed and y vary from 1 to 3. so 7k plus 10k plus 13k is equal to 30k is equal to 30 by 70. and total sum of this marginal distribution for x is equal to 1. So 30 plus 24, 54 plus 18, 72 by 72 is equal to 1. Now we find marginal distribution for 1 and denoted by P star j, where star represent the variable quantity and j is fixed. So if y equal to 1, total sum of the probability denoted by marginal distribution for y equal to 1, 3 plus 5, 8 plus 5, 7, 15k. For y equal to 2, 6 plus 8, 14 plus 10, 24k. And in last case, 9 plus 11, 20, 13, 33. And in this case, total probability 33 plus 24k. So 33 plus 15, 30, 48, and plus so 72k, and k equal to 1 by 72, so total probability equal to 1. So total marginal distribution for x and for y always is equal to 1. Sum of the total probability of or total marginal distribution for x is equal to 1, and total marginal distribution for y is also equal to 1. Similarly, conditional distribution of x equal of x given that y equal to 1. So in this case, we find the conditional probability distribution for x equal to 0 when y equal to 1. Pi 1, where y is given and x is variable. So x equal to 0 and y equal to 1, in this case, x equal to 0 and y equal to 1, the probability is equal to 3k, and probability marginal for y equal to 1 is given by 15k. So conditional probability of x equal to 0 and y equal to 1 given by 1 by 5. Similarly, we can find probability of x equal to 1 and 2. And the total of these probabilities is also equal to. And similarly, we can find for y equal to 2 and y equal to 3. And the next slide show the conditional probability distribution of y given that x equal to 1, 0 and 2. So in this case also, if x is given, then conditional probability of x equal to y equal to 1 given that x equal to 0 given by probability of x equal to 1 and y equal to 1 and x equal to 0 and marginal for x equal to 0 in this case. So first case, when y equal to 1 and x equal to 0 is 3k, and marginal for x equal to 0 is given by 18k. So conditional probability of y given that x equal to 0 is equal to 1 by 7. And similarly, we can find for 2 and 3 in second case when x equal to 1, and in that case conditional probability distribution of y equal to 1, 2 and 3 case, and in the last table when x equal to 2 is given, and then conditional probability of y when y, 1, 2 and 3 are given in this case.